All right, Shalom, Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Rakakwadash. Double honors to my teachers, the apostles, and elders of Great Millstone. Much respect to the brothers laboring worldwide in truth and sincerity, and salutations and blessings to the hopeful elect, believing on the words of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah. Title of this lesson is going to be Plantation Christianity and Other Topics, Lord willing, is edifying. Okay, now I have a couple of clips that I want to share. All right, and you know, our people are just gone, man. You know, even with this truth being presented to them, they still can't get it. They still want to hold on to that deception, right? Matter of fact, let's start out with something real quick. All right. And as you see that picture on the screen, you know, that's two-thirds of our people just lost. You know, they get a feel-good message. All right. Pastor tell them you're going to receive a blessing. And then what? They pass around the collection plate. All right. All the things that the Lord, you know, warned us about. All right. Let's go to 2 Thessalonians. Because our people are deceived. Even with this truth being readily available, all right, being preached to them, they have no understanding, right? So I want to start, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 and verse 10. And with all deceivableness of unrighteousness, and them that perish, why are these people going to perish? Because they receive not the love of the truth that they might be saved. See? And this is truly as the elder Apostle Gabar been mentioning on his, for all the time, but lately on the last couple of his videos, that we are such in a blessed position to understand and have the knowledge of Yahweh Bashiach. All right? As you can plainly see, two-thirds of our people can't get it. It says, verse 11, and for this cause, the Most High shall send them strong delusion that they should believe a lie. Yeah, Christianity, plantation Christianity, is a lie, man. All right? It's very unfruitful. All right? It's the only religion, per se, because we don't have a religion. We have laws, statutes, commandments that the Lord gave us. All right, but Christianity, plantation Christianity, is a religion. It tells you got to die to make it to the kingdom of heaven, man. Which is totally going off. But that's the racket that Esau set up. Verse 12, it says, that they all might be damned who believe not. See that? Who believe not, but had pleasure in unrighteousness, you see? And two-thirds of our people have pleasure in unrighteousness, all right? They shun the ways of the Lord, all right? Even though it's being presented to them, it's being broken down to them constantly. But that's just their lot, all right? That's the lot that the Lord chose for them to play, all right? Now I want to play a couple of videos. All right, so you can see the ignorance of our people, man. See it? That's foolery, man. Foolery. Jake is caught up in this racket that Esau has set up, man. All right? Straight up foolishness. Dancing around like some fools. And you know, we've all been in that Southern Baptist Pentecostal church, man. They spread the chairs and they so-called catch the Holy Ghost. All right, but there's nothing but demons on these people, man. There's nothing but demons on them, right? Let's go back. Just foolery, man. And as that, it says, this stunt is why church folks are so doctrinally dumb. Yeah, you doctrinally dumb. All right, you believe you can still eat abomination, thinking the Lord has did away with his laws. That's what Christianity teaches, man. It teaches you to be lawless, right? It teaches you lawlessness, matter of fact. And that's beautiful how the Lord set that up. Let's go back to 2 Thessalonians. Let's read up. Okay? Because Christianity, plantation Christianity, teaches lawlessness, right? And what does it say at the top? Man of lawlessness. You see that? And who is that man of lawlessness? Esau, Edom, the so-called white man. All right? And I want to get to the point so we can have understanding. Okay? 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, and we'll start at verse 3. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come, except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed. Who is the man of sin? Esau, even the so-called white man. The son of perdition. Yeah, the son of destruction. He was destined, formed, shaped, and fashioned to be destroyed. Right? It says, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called the Most High, or that is worshipped, so that he as power sitteth in the temple of the Most High, showing himself that he is the Most High. See? Remember ye not that when I was yet with you, I told you these things, and these things are being brought up by our pure minds being stirred up by the way of remembrance, right? And ye know what withholding, that he might be revealed in his time. And that's another thing. All the ill dealings of this devil is being revealed in this time, who he is according to the scriptures. And you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans still won't turn from your wickedness. You still wrapped up in plantation Christianity. But we read earlier in this same chapter, all right, that the Lord gave you over to that strong delusion, right? It says, for the mystery of iniquity doeth already work, only now who letteth will let, until he be taken out of the way. See, it's the Lord letting this devil, all right, continue with his wickedness until his time is up. All right? It says, and then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. And right now this devil is being consumed by the spirit of the Lord's mouth, man, by the way of his prophets, all right? It says, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power, right, and signs and lying wonders, and he has deceived the minds of our people, all right? He's the god of the of these plantation Christianities, right? You see him, man. And what do you see? You see Eve. That's all you see. You see Eve, man. Eve is being beguiled by the serpent once again. See? Let's go back to another video. Because I got another video. You know. Eve, man. Dude. Check this out. Let me let it load. Hey, and what you hear? A feel-good message. That's what you hear. You ain't hearing the words of the Lord. You ain't hearing repent, right? To give you a friend you can dance with. No more enemies. Real, real friends. No more enemies. Real, real friends. Real, real friends.
ones that are not jealous, ones that are not going to hurt you. God sent.
And E got demons on him, man. But that's just showing you more how this devil has deceived, all right, and has caused our people to err, all right? They have no understanding, okay? They're going to continue to be in this world until what? Isaiah 6 and 9 be fulfilled, until the city be utterly wasted, all right? They're going to know it after death by pain, man, all right? Let's go back to the scriptures. Because that's what you're seeing, man. You're seeing two-thirds of our people still clinging on to their slave master. And the Lord ain't in those churches, man. He ain't dealing with those churches, right? This is the book of Acts, chapter 7 and verse 48. Howbeit, the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands, as saith the prophet. See, the Lord ain't dwelling in those temples, man. All right, those are harlot houses. All right, as our apostles and elders have taught us, man, those are harlot houses. All right, in the world, you wanted a quick fix. Where would you go? You'll go to the harlot house, man. You'll go to those ones professing that they're holy. All right, but they got all type of demons on them. It says, verse 49, heaven is my throne, and the earth is my footstool. What house will ye build, saith the Lord, or what is the place of my rest? That's right. You can't build a house to the Lord, Yahweh Shabbat. All right? It's impossible. Okay? And the Lord ain't dwelling in those churches anyway, man. Where they teach you to commit all type of abominations, man. All right? They teach you to be lawless. Okay? Just as we read. All right, they following after the way of Esau, their master. Okay, and that's another reason why they're gonna take that. They're gonna take that thing. They're gonna take that digital off. Why? Because they haven't been sanctified by the truth of Yahweh by Shabbat. Okay, this is Isaiah, chapter 29, and verse 13. Wherefore the Lord said, "For as much as this people draw near with their mouth and their lips do honor me." Yeah, praise God. Praise sweet Jesus, right? With your words, you honor the Lord, but not according to knowledge, right? Let's get that real quick. Let's go to the book of Romans. And there's a penalty for not hearkening to the report, all right? There's a penalty for not coming back to Yahweh Shabbat Shah in spirit and in truth. What's that penalty? It's death. Romans chapter 10 and verse 1. Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to the Most High for Israel. Now, this is the Apostle Paul writing to the scattered Israelites in Rome. That's why it's personalized, brethren. It says prayer to the Most High for Israel, not for everybody. It says that they might be saved. See that? So of course, we have compassion on our people, but the Lord is showing us more and more why they have to be, you know, put away, as it were. Verse 2, for I bear them record that they have a zeal of the Most High, but not according to knowledge. You see that? And what's the knowledge that they don't have? All right, the ways of the Heavenly Father. All right, to fear him, all right, to do what he say do, or you're going to die, man. They don't have that knowledge of the Lord, right? For they being ignorant of the Most High's righteousness and going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted, yeah, that word submit, being under the rule. You have not submitted to Yahweh by Shabbat. It says have not submitted, right, themselves unto the righteousness of the Most High. See that? See, you don't want to follow the ways of the Heavenly Father. Again, you those same spirits that are back, that's always come up against the Heavenly Father and His Son, right? Back in Isaiah 29 and verse 13, it says, wherefore the Lord said, For as much as this people draw near to me with their mouth and with their lips do honor me, but have removed their heart from me. Yeah, your heart, your mind. That word heart in the Hebrew is the word lab. Let's get that. Let's prove it. Right? You hear these wacky tag Christians. The Lord know my heart. Yeah, he do know your heart. Right? A word, Strong's H, 3820, lob, right? Inner man, mind, see? Mind. You see that? And you see Esau will throw that in. But we can plainly read where it says, out of the heart of man come evil things, right? But that's your mind, okay? Down to the fourth definition, it says mind, knowledge, thinking, reflection, memory. See that? So it's your mind. That's what this heart is, according to the scriptures. You see? Back in Isaiah 29 and 13, it says, but have removed their heart, your mind, far from me, and the fear toward me is taught by the precept of me. See that? See, they don't have the fear of Yahweh Shavashah. All right? These plantation Christians, all right, are being taught by these false prophets. You can do what you want to do. The Lord is just going to forgive you. And that's why this world is laid in wickedness, man. That's why you see the world decreasing. Because of all the wickedness that has been shown upon the planet Earth, man. It's coming. All right? The destruction is coming. All right? Just as in the days of Noah. These things are going to happen again. Because you refuse to repent, man, and you're going to be caught out there. All right, for those who hear Yahweh Shavashah, all right, pushing forth his word and understanding, all right, those are going to be saved. All right, verse 14, therefore, behold, I will proceed to do a marvelous work among this people. It says, even a marvelous work. And wonder, for the wisdom of their wise men shall perish, and the understanding of their prudent men shall be hid. That's right. We fell away from our heritage. We read that in 2 Thessalonians. But now the Lord has let us see our teachers, man. All right. He's now brought us up, all right, with this counsel. Okay. This is Matthew chapter 15. And this Yahweh Shah quoting the prophet Isaiah, right? It says, ye hypocrites, well did Isaiah prophesy of you, saying, this people draw not unto me with their mouth and honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. See that? They're far from Yahweh Shah. It says, but in vain do they worship me, teaching for doctrines the commandments of men. See, and Yahweh was speaking to these wicked Pharisees about the disciples not washing their hands. All right, and that's just one of the things that these wicked Pharisees, you know, came up against Yahweh about. All right, and the Lord made it plain, is that not what goes in a man that defiled of him. And you see these wacky tacky Christians that use this, but the Lord was talking about washing hands. All right. How much more these people who's into this false Christianity, man? All right. Who don't follow the ways of the Lord, Yahweh Shavashah, who's in this plantation Christianity, as our elder pastor Gabar coined it, right? And you pastors, man. All right. This truth has been pushed forth and published. And you still leading the sheep astray, matter of fact. Let's go to Jeremiah, right? This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 23 and verse 1, right? It says, woe be unto the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, saith the Lord. See that? Woe means what? Destruction, death. Therefore, thus saith the Lord, power of Israel, against the pastors that feed my people, ye have scattered my flock. and driven them away, and have not visited them, behold, I will visit upon you the evil of your doings, saith the Lord, Yahabashah. See? So when these times, all right, these hard times that you're not preparing the sheep for come to pass, guess what? Those sheep gonna turn on you, man. All right? And they're gonna require that of you. Okay, because you haven't been giving them the right one. You've been giving them a plantation Christianity, a feel-good message. See? And the Lord is going to require that of you. All right? Now, I have this other video, man. It's so crazy. Matter of fact, let's go back to the scriptures. Okay? Let's go back to the scriptures. Amen. But see, now we understand. Because you've been thoroughly warned, and the Lord has had his word have free course. All right? This is Isaiah chapter 30, verse 20. And though the Lord give you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore, but thine eyes shall see thy teachers. And that's what's being happening now. You're able to see the real teachers of Yahabashah. It's going to feed you what you're supposed to be fed. Matter of fact, staying in the book of Jeremiah, or going back to the book of Jeremiah, chapter 3, right? Because now you have no excuse. Your eyes are seeing your teachers, all right? It says, Jeremiah, chapter 3 and verse 14, turn, O backsliding children, say of the Lord, for I am married unto you, and I will take you one of a city and two of a family and bring you to Zion. See that? That's why it's a very small number that's going to understand this truth, right? It says, verse 15, and I will give you pastors according to mine heart, my mind, right, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. And these wicked-ass pastors are not feeding our people with knowledge and understanding. All right? But the real teachers, okay, start with our head apostles and elders, all right, have diligently, all right, declared all the words of Yahabashah, the good and the bad. We ain't left nothing out. Start with our apostles and elders. All right? Now, back in Isaiah chapter 30, verse 20, and though the Lord give you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore, but thine eyes shall see thy teachers, and thine ears shall hear a word behind thee, saying, this is the way, walk ye in it, when ye turn to the right hand, or when ye turn to the left. That's right. We're walking in the ways of Yahabashah. All right? And two-thirds of our people shun that counsel. Okay? Verse 22, ye shall also defile the coverings of thy graven images of silver and the ornaments of thy molten images of gold. Yeah, we had any kind of crosses or anything like that in our house, all right, or around our neck. We got rid of that shit, right? Thou shalt cast them away as a menstruous cloth. That's why, hey, man, we settled, rooted, and grounded over here. All right, you can't come up to us with that plantation shit. All right, that plantation Christianity. No, it won't work. It says, and that's why we cast it away as a menstrual cloth. Thou shalt say unto thee, get thee hence. That's right. Get away from us with that shit. All right, because we know it's all lies. All right. Now, I have another video. Brace yourself. It's Jake. Jake is an idiot. Look at this shit, man. Just look. As you see the title, it says, so many questions, right? So many questions. Let's play it. Make sure this volume down.
Are you okay? Like, really? I'm fine. If I'ma be sad, I'ma do it with pizzazz. And shake these feelings off my ass. Define me in some glitter if I crash. Do it with pizzazz. Cause if the feeling never passed.
Do you see this dumbass shit, man? This guy has a dog carrier in his fucking pants. And this is Israel, man.
At least I flip the shit and it's some cash. Do it with pizzazz. Every hour spending isolation makes it easier to face annihilation. I'ma do it with pizzazz.
You see this? That's why I said brace yourself. Going into other topics.
People, you gonna shake or be shaking, and not just shake the.
You see it? You see it? You see it? Yeah, ain't too many words can be said for that. Let's stay in the book of, go back to Jeremiah chapter 4. This is Jeremiah chapter 4 and verse 22. For my people is foolish. They have not known me. They are sottish children. That word sottish means stupid. It says, and they have none understanding. They are wise to do evil, but to do good, they have no knowledge. You see that? To do good, they have no knowledge. And this plainly is some of the worst shit I have ever seen, man. This is some of the worst shit I have ever seen. You know, this, you got a dog in your goddamn pants. You see this? Jake just the whole head is sick, man. I did in the lesson earlier today, man. The whole head is sick. And somebody's trying to market this. Somebody's trying to sell these pants, man. That's Jake, man. It makes no sense. But again, that's why the Lord said, my people are foolish. They are sottish children, right? No understanding. Okay? This is 2 Ezra. 2 Ezra chapter 9. And I'm going to start at verse 7. It says, and everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works, and by faith, whereby ye have believed. See, two-thirds are not going to believe in the counsel of Yahweh by Shalshah. Why? Because it hadn't been revealed to them, matter of fact. Let's go back to Isaiah. Chapter 53. The Lord hadn't been revealed to them. That's why they don't know the Heavenly Father. That's why they don't know the fear. Well, the fear of the Lord. Isaiah 53 and 1. Who have believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? You see that? It's not revealed to everybody. All right? And ultimately, that's why, you know, they're going to die. Okay? Back in 2 Ezra chapter 9. And we'll read 7 again. And everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith, whereby ye have believed, shall be preserved from the said perils and see my salvation in my land and within my borders, for I have sanctified them for me from the beginning. See that? Those certain spirits were sanctified by Yahweh Shalshah from the beginning to receive salvation. And Lord willing, we part of that number. And in the contrast, right? Then that shall they be in pitiful case, which now have abused my ways, and they that cast them away despitefully shall dwell in torment. See, you cast these words behind, you're going to dwell in torment. That's going to be your abode. No relief. It says, for such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me. See, they don't know the Heavenly Father. They don't know that he's poised and ready to destroy this place. All right, that he's pronounced evil on Babylon. Okay, it says, verse 11, and they that have loathed my law while they had yet liberty, and when as yet place of repentance was open unto them, understood not but despised it. You see that? And that's the thing, man. You can hear the gospel being preached, but if you don't understand, if you're not built that way to get it, you're going to automatically despise it. See that? The same. See that? The same must know it after death by pain. And that's when Jake gonna get it. All right? When he back before the Heavenly Father. When he back before the throne of Yahweh by Shashah, that's when he's gonna get it. Okay? Now I have like two more videos I want to show. Okay? And yeah, check this out. Let me let it load. All right. Because these people in their security, they're going to be destroyed, man. And when I seen this this video, man, I was like, damn. It says, Bear, do you think it's safe to hide in your home? Okay. Let's play it. Hey, that's how the Lord coming, man. You're not gonna have anywhere to hide. Oh, that brings up a precept, right? Let's get it. Let's go to the book of Amos, right? As if a man met a lion or ran from a bear, right? Let's get it. Amos chapter 5. And bear with me, verse 18. Yep, it says, woe to unto you that desire the day of the Lord. Yeah, it's talking to you plantation Christianities, man. You lost in the sauce of Babylon the Great. It says, to what end is it for you? The day of the Lord is darkness and not light. As if a man did flee from a lion and a bear met him, or went into the house and leaned his hand on the wall and a serpent bit him. Shall not the day of the Lord, Yahweh shall be darkness and not light, even very dark and no brightness in it? You see that? So ain't no getting away. And that's what that video, you know, reminded me of. All right, you're not getting away from the Heavenly Father. All right, when he sent out those death angels, those teeth of wild beasts, all right, the sword, Esau ate them. Guess what? There's no way you're gonna escape. Okay, let's play the video again. See that? Says, it's already done. Dawn. Why hasn't he come out yet? The bear is sitting on the couch. Wait. That's what it is. Hey, what is that? Ezekiel, where it says, let's get it. Ezekiel 7. Yeah, the bear is waiting for you to come out. And the Lord said the end is already waiting for you. Ezekiel 7, and let's start at verse 5. It says, thus saith the Lord, power and evil and only evil, behold, is come. An end is come. The end is come. It watcheth for thee. See, it watcheth for thee. Behold, it is come. Hey, and that bell. It's lucky I wouldn't even share the scripture. Let me share the scripture. All right, we'll read it again. But that bell, all right, he was way. He ain't go nowhere. He sat there all through the morning, waiting. Okay, let's go back. It's lucky. Yeah. He waited. Let's read the scripture again. Ezekiel chapter 7 and verse 5. Thus saith the Lord, power and evil and only evil, behold, is come. An end is come. the end is come and watching for thee. And that's what this bell is doing. All right. He was watching for whoever that person was that slammed that door. All right. That little dog, too. It was just a matter of time before the Lord put him to death. All right. Now I have one more video that I want to share. All right. And I thought this video, you know, again, was very spiritual, because all the pieces are lining up. Everything is right in its place. All right. The Lord has everything set, and it's just a matter of time before his will, all right, is fulfilled. Okay. Let's play the video. See, everything was moving at his own pace. And that's how the Lord has us, man. He's directing our steps. Okay? He's moving us at the pace that he has desired. Hey, and that's how the prophecies are. Everything is falling into place. As the elder, Elder Brother Our Rump saying, all right, everybody's falling into their lap. All right, the two-thirds are showing forth the wickedness. All right, those are the ones that believe on Yahweh Shah Shah are getting built up in the faith. All right, if you was a prophet, you prophesying. If you a teacher, you teaching. See? See that? That's beautiful. All right. Everything is lining up the way the Lord said it would. All right. We get two precepts and we'll close it out. First is get the book of Isaiah. Been in Isaiah, prophet of the Lord. Isaiah chapter 55, right? And let's get to the point. We'll start at verse 10. It says, for as the rain cometh down and the snow from heaven and returneth not thither, but water of the earth and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. Yeah, this word is coming down from Yahweh Shah. All right, and it's feeding us with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void. And just as the rain cometh down, don't return unto the Lord void as the snow. The Lord words are not empty, okay? But it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it. See? So when we see all these pieces, these puzzles falling into place, that's the words of the Heavenly Father coming to pass. The wicked being revealed, the elect in the word, all right? The two-thirds shunning the gospel, Yahweh Shah Shah. All these things are now what? Falling into place, all right? Lord will, it's been edifying. I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahawashah, Bahashem, Wakakadash. Double honors to my teachers, the apostles, and elders of Great Millstone. Lord willing, coming at you with another lesson. Till the next time I say Shalom, DTA, and Abba Baal. Soon. Shalom.